Hello, I'm Chris Menard. In today's Excel video, I'm going to show you how to calculate year-over-year analysis using a pivot table. So this is a great video. In case you're wondering what is year-over-year analysis, it's not always comparing one year to another, even though that's still year-over-year analysis, but it could even be quarters. I want to do the first quarter of 2022 versus the first quarter of 2021. That is called year-over-year analysis. It could also be monthly, August of 2022 versus August of 2021. And just to show you something real quick, I'm going to throw on this Excel file a screenshot of Microsoft, and I even highlighted it in yellow to show you this. Total company revenue climbed almost 22% year over year, but they're looking at stuff quarterly in this example. So here we go. I've got 24 months of data. I pulled in some views, but this could be revenue. It could be whatever numbers you want it to be. Let's go make a pivot table, insert pivot table, put it on a new sheet. Perfect. I've only got two fields. You only need two fields for this, the date field and whatever it is you want to summarize. I'm going to check date. I'm going to check views. There we go. Zoomed in just a tad. Click on one of the dates. So I clicked on A4. Pivot table analyze, the group tab, do an ungroup. So there are my 24 months again, by the way. Now I go back to group. How do you want to group this? I could do quarters if I wanted to, because I just showed you Microsoft's quarterly year to year, but I want to do months. So I'm going to check months. I'm also going to check years. Click OK. There's everything for 2020 and there's everything for 2021. Drag years and drop it into the columns. All right, so there we go, the 12 months for 2 years. Grand total in column D is not needed. I'm going to right click on cell D4 and remove it. Now, I could do the year over year percentage analysis right here by doing equals C5 divided by B5 minus 1. That is 122% growth, but I want to do it inside the pivot table in case my data changes or I rearrange it. So this is the cool part of this video. I'm going to take views again, and again, it's whatever you want to look at. I'm going to drop it into the values again. So now I end up with at least four columns, and I do next to the months, 1, 2, 3, 4. That last column in E, it says sum of views 2. Right click it, show value as, and notice I'm going to go to percentage difference from. If I want to know the dollar difference, I would have done the one above it, just difference from, but I want to know the percentage. If you recall, I got 122% a second ago. You want to make sure that this is years, not date. And base item is the previous year. So now when I hit OK in cell E6, I should see 122%, and I do. The key to this also is not only just doing what I just did, but column C you don't need. So here's the easy tip, just hide it. So there you go. I'm gonna test these real quick. I'm gonna do exactly what I just did a second ago. -1, I just like to check numbers. And I got the wrong formula already. It's B6. D6 divided by B6. Perfect. Crosshairs, double click. Percentage. I'm just taking a quick look to show you that it did work. That's all. All right. So that is year over year analysis using a pivot table in Microsoft Excel. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. If you have any comments or questions, please put them down below. Have a wonderful day. I appreciate your time, by the way.